A Carabao Cup final preview without Manchester City, something we haven't said for quite some time, Ali Moreno, but we've got a really good matchup, Chelsea against Liverpool. Is this game more important for either of the two sides over the other one, or just as important for both?
It's a final, and so therefore, by definition, it should be important to both teams. Now, in terms of who needs it the most, I suppose you have to say Chelsea. It's hard to think of a team that is in a cup final, is in a knockout competition in Champions League, and will potentially move on to the next round in that competition. And yet you feel, when you encapsulate the whole season, you think that it has been a disappointment because of how far back they are from Manchester City and Liverpool in the title race. They would have expected to have been in the title race. They are not. And so how do you mask that? How do you put makeup on that? How you sort of kind of dress up what has been a disappointing Premier League season for you? Well, you win Carabao Cup final, and that allows you to, at the very least, put some eyeshadow on what has otherwise been, yes, a disappointing, underwhelming season, at least domestically.
It's a trophy, Ali, that many of the Premier League teams kind of play, some reserves, some first teams in the early stages. But I think we've seen with the caliber of teams in the final over the last several years, this means a lot to all teams involved because it's the first chance as well to get your hands on some silverware.
Yes, and so whatever feelings you may have about your season currently, you go and win this cup and you're like, hey, hey, look at us. Look, we're winners. That's what we do. We're number one. Yes, it creates a sense of achievement and accomplishment and may just sort of kind of push you on to the rest of the season and give you that sense of accomplishment that you need to have within a locker room to have the confidence to not only challenge for big things, but feel good about what's going on around you. And so that's why I sort of lean towards Chelsea in saying they need it the most, because there's been some comings and goings inside that locker room. The story of Romelu Lukaku simply doesn't seem to go away. And now we're focusing more on King Kai Havertz, who's now the guy who's going to score the goals for Chelsea. And those storylines and Thomas Tuchel, it's all been sort of topsy-turvy. It's always been percolating and marinating on sort of under the surface. We feel like something's about to happen in Chelsea. You win this, then everything just kind of calms down and you focus on what's ahead. As for Liverpool, you get to the final. Now it becomes truly important, truly significant because, yeah, you want to live that trophy. Whatever the trophy is, whatever the competition is, we always hear of elite clubs around the world. We win everything that we enter. That's why we play. That's why we're there. Okay, well, here you are in a cup final, and Liverpool should be the favorites coming in.
Okay, let's isolate both teams and chat about them respectively. Chelsea, do you start Romelu Lukaku, given Kai Havertz's recent scoring form and the fact that Tuchel said he took Lukaku out of the firing line in the Champions League in midweek? Do you think he starts?
I think he's going to start. And hopefully he's going to get more than seven touches. Hey, Romelu's really participating in the game. I think he starts, but I think he has a very short run out there. If he doesn't impact the game, if he doesn't change the game, if he doesn't have significant participation in the game early on, then I think Thomas Tuchel has reached the point to where he's saying, we can't do this anymore. I think you start him because you feel that he can score a goal for you. But then again, this is why you brought him to begin with, is that you thought this guy was going to be the one scoring the goals. And the reason you thought that this guy was going to be the one scoring goals for you was because Kai Havertz was not scoring the goals for you. Timo Werner was not scoring the goals for you. And the fact that you now have to kind of take a step back and lean on Kai Havertz and say, hey, Kai, guess what? I believe in you. I never lost hope and confidence that you were going to be the guy. Well, you did, because you brought this other guy in thinking that he was going to score the goals. And now you have this sort of coming and going of players who were supposed to be the answer but haven't been with any sort of consistency.
The only thing that Thiago Silva didn't have in midweek in the Champions League was a cigar, because he absolutely strolled through that game. The Chelsea defence, assuming they play three, if they do, or regardless, against the Liverpool front three, advantage who?
advantage Liverpool. But that's dependent upon how the game flows. If it becomes a back and forth open game, then definitely advantage Liverpool and that front three. If everything is fast paced, then Liverpool, that's where they thrive. When it becomes a little chaotic, when it becomes a little disorganized and Liverpool has a lot of players in and around the ball, that's where Chelsea may just get stretched. And if they get stretched, then Liverpool, the front three, certainly would take advantage, even of a guy like Thiago Silva, who, as you just mentioned, was very comfortable in the midweek, but that's because everything was in front of him. And yeah, at this point in his career, he wants no part of people running by him and running in behind and runs out of the midfield and guys floating around all around him. While he can organize everything in front of him, if they start chasing, going the wrong direction, that's where Chelsea may just be in trouble. And Thiago Silva himself may find that he will have a difficult time chasing around Liverpool players.
Okay, let's talk Liverpool now. Can Mohamed Salah be stopped?
He can for larger periods of the game, but he has reached a point in his career in which he doesn't need to have too many opportunities. I think for Mohamed Salah, what we have seen over the years that has improved dramatically is that he used to get a lot of chances and miss a lot of chances. Now, while he would keep scoring goals back then, now he doesn't seem to need as many opportunities to kill the game for you. And while he may be stuck for large periods of the game, and you may say to yourself, man, this guy's not doing much. Man, he's not really impacting the game. Man, he's not really doing things for Liverpool right now. You keep him on the field because there are moments now in which he is head and shoulders above everybody else. And that's why he has taken his game to a different level and to an elite level, and that doesn't need as many chances, scoring a lot of important goals for Liverpool and doing that in key moments for Liverpool. And well, it doesn't get any more of a key moment than in a cup final.
Last time the sides met at Stamford Bridge, Liverpool were two goals up early. They didn't win the game. Can Jurgen Klopp learn anything from that 19 minutes that can help him this time around?
I think what's important for Liverpool is that, as I spoke about earlier, that they understand what the game should look like if they are going to be successful. It has to be fast-paced. Chelsea does not want this to be fast-paced. So you got to speed that process of what is it that you want to do and make sure that Chelsea fall into that trap. If you sort of get frustrated because Chelsea will put numbers behind the ball, because they'll force you into mistakes, because they'll force you into turnovers, and then they're going on the counter and trying to get their opportunities that way, and then you lose your own rhythm and you lose your own ability to speed up the game, that's perhaps where Liverpool has a problem. But I think Jurgen Klopp is going to be very clear to his players, is we're going to make this back and forth. We're going to pressure high up the field. We're going to be on top of them. We're not going to let them breathe. We are not going to play this game at their pace. We're going to play it at our pace, at our speed, and in our rhythm. And that's how we win the game. If Liverpool do that, I think they're significantly better than Chelsea.
It's a super matchup. It promises to be a super final. Full coverage on ESPN FC.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.